looking beautiful. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Carol Layla, and I'm duly authorised by law to solemnise marriages according to law. And we're gathered here this afternoon to celebrate the marriage of Stuart and Tiana. And I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you all here and thank you for coming, but also to remind you that it's not just another day. It's a very special day for our bride and groom to acknowledge their commitment to each other. Since time immemorial, people have performed ceremonies to mark a transition or a change of status. Today we gather for the happiest of ceremonies, the change of status from single individuals to a married couple. And that traditionally that change is indicated by passing the bride's hand from her family to her husband-to-be. I will now ask, who brings this woman here today to marry this man? Thank you. Stuart, would you like to go and get your bride?
No, you're not going to be here.
Thank you. Great. Just at the back would be nice. Just at the back. Yeah. Okay. Center yourself. Over a bit. Tiana and Stuart, before you're joined in marriage in my presence and in the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship you are about to enter into. Marriage, according to the law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others voluntarily entered into for life. May I have the rings, please?
Hello.
Thank you, Jess. That's beautiful. Perfect. Thank you. Yes. Now, I'd like to ask our two mums to come forward, please. Ladies, would you like to just take one of these bags for me, please, and just take them back and hang on to them for me? Our mums, I'm placing these rings into the hands of Lorraine and Andrea, and our mums will hold these rings in their hands during our ceremony, and as they hold them, they will warm them with their love and silently give good wishes and blessings to the couple that will wear them. These rings will not only be a gift from one to another, but they'll be given with the love, support and wisdom of your families. Now, Stu and Tiz met 6 years ago today after a small interaction on Tinder when David Reynolds won at Bathurst. Their first date was to Subway in Tiz's lunch break, and they didn't stop talking for the full half hour. And I guess you could say the spark was lit. The next day they met up again and the flame was very much alive, and they have been inseparable ever since. They are very committed and supportive of each other, and they worked hard to purchase their home in 2019, which they share with Quinn, formerly known as Stu's dog, but is now known as Tiana's dog. Their shared interests in camping, travelling Australia, adventure and music has seen them develop a great partnership. Stuart, as we know, is very stubborn, very stubborn. Tiana is the extrovert, but between them, they've formed a relationship that's based on honesty, trust, respect, loyalty and spontaneity.
And that leads us to finding ourselves in this lovely setting today, celebrating their marriage. And although this is a high point, marriage is a journey, not a destination. Marriage is more than any one single event or promise. It is a series of decisions that have been made and will continue to be made over and over again that reminds each other of their care and concern for the one whom they love. Marriage is a promise that is renewed daily through a couple's actions and a responsibility taken on in the spirit of faith, hope and love that brings comfort in times of sadness and heightens our greatest joys. Stu and Tiz, would you like to now face each other and join hands? How are we going to do this? Scissors, paper, rock?
Yeah, can I fix my veil?
Yep. Great. I'll put it under me.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. We're going to scissors, paper, rock here. And
winner goes first.
Okay. Scissors, paper, rock. Okay. Holy doing.
Tiana, dear, take Stuart to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish from this day forward until death do you part.
I do.
Good. Please repeat after me.
I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present
to witness that I,
Tiana
Gay Smart,
take you,
Stuart Bradenshaw, to be my lawful wedded husband, from this day forward, you shall not walk alone, my heart will be your shelter,
and my arms will be your home,
That's perfect. There you go. Now, Tiana has some words that she would like to say to Stuart.
Geez, that's long.
I've been writing essays for the last 2 years.
Do you want me to fact check it?
Yeah, please go to
no.
Okay. Stu, who would have thought that swiping right on Tinder 6 years ago would lead us to this special day? I'll also never let you live it down that you swiped right first.
Debatable.
There's not a day that goes by where I'm not grateful for calling you mine and the life we've created together. I can think of no one else I'd rather be silly with, travel Australia, but annoy for the rest of my life. I love your smile, your cheeky personality, and how intelligent you are. It reassures me that I'll never have to call an electrician, a mechanic, a plumber, or a handyman because I'm marrying a jack of all trades.
Master of none.
I admire your patience, determination, resilience, and how you take it upon yourself to water my plants every afternoon. I appreciate your honesty, advice, knowledge, and presence in helping me achieve success in my life and career, and I wouldn't be where I am today without your support and faith in me to succeed. Thank you for buying the Patrol those few years ago and reintroducing my love to country music, camping, and an ambitious plan to travel Australia. We've travelled many kilometres together and camped in some of the most ridiculous places.
Peterborough.
Thank you for not only giving me yourself to fall in love with, but Quinn. I absolutely adore her loving cuddles, her energetic personality, and the growth of her new grey hairs that you both now share. While we have achieved so much together already, it is our plans for the future that excite me the most. I promise to always be your side and be the one you can always turn to. I promise to be kind, patient, and forgiving, and never give up when the times are hard. I promise to cherish our marriage, to make you laugh, to make our life fun, and to forever keep making memories. You are my best friend, Stu, and I promise to show you how much I love you for the rest of my life.
Stuart, dear, take Tiana to heaven to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish from this day forward until death do you part.
I do.
Please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Stuart Bradenshaw.
Stuart Bradenshaw.
Take you.
Take you.
Tiana Gay Smart.
Tiana Gay Smart.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
And my arms will be your home.
And my arms will be your home.
Do you need to hold your essay?
Just one page. Tis. Ever since the 2017 Bathurst 1000, when David Reynolds won, and then at Subway next to Wollongong Hospital, on this very day 6 years ago, we've been completely inseparable. Here is some of the annoying stuff I will continue with.
There we go.
I will try to always turn the smoke alarm off when you're cooking. Because I can reach it. Oh,
funny.
I promise to rewash the patrol when you've done a half-assed job and left dirt in the gutters. I'll always hang the washing out when you sneakily put it on and then go out for the day. I will continue to repack the dishwasher because you put the biggest Tupperware container we own where the cup should go. It ruins my feng shui. I vow to laugh and correct your misuse of words, like when you say someone has fogged you off or you brought a new dress. And I will always have to leave for the toilet whenever we have to pack up our campsite, secretly watching from afar so I can return when all the hard stuff's done.
Yes, always.
But now for the mushy, serious stuff. I will always be honest, open, and listen to you. I promise to cherish the moments we share, big or small. I vow to support you in all your endeavours and to stand by your side through all of the challenges. And I can't wait to spend every day with you and see what the future brings.
I'm just going to have to pop these away. Mums, may I have the rings, please? Just tip them out of the bag and give me the rings.
Hi.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, Mums. Stu and Tiana. The passage to the status of husband and wife is also marked by the exchange of rings. The circle of rings has always represented eternal love, as they have neither a beginning nor an end. And these rings, now warmed by those who love you, contain in their precious metal the priceless gifts of love, hope and support for our bride and groom, and will forever show the world that you are one. And may they always remind you of the vows you have taken. No, just do it.
Oh, okay.
Okay. May as well. Please. Tears, I place this ring on your finger.
Tears, I place this ring on your finger.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love and
commitment.
Please wear it with faith.
Please wear it with faith.
For it is the visible symbol.
For it is the visible symbol.
That I will always love and respect you.
That I will always love and respect you.
And as I give you this ring to wear.
And as I give you this ring to wear.
I give you my life to share.
I give you my life to share.
Thank you, Tamar. Please repeat that to me. Stu, I place this ring on your finger.
Stu, I place this ring on your finger.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
Please wear it with faith.
Please wear it with faith.
For it is the visible symbol.
For it is the visible symbol.
That I will always love and respect.
That I will always love and respect you.
And as I give you this ring to wear.
And as I give you this ring to wear.
I give you my life to share.
I give you my life to share.
Deanna and Stuart, you have declared before all of us that you will live together in marriage. You have made special promises to each other, which have been symbolised by the joining of hands, taking of vows, and the giving and receiving of two rings. May you always be aware of the love you share and retain the strength you need to keep the promises you have made today. It is now my very, very great pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife and invite you to seal the marriage with a kiss. Stuart, you may now kiss your bride.
It's a Master Champagne Award right there.
Just looking at this one. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Thanks, guys. She's so happy.
Today is a new beginning. Today is the start of a new journey as husband and wife. And on behalf of everyone here, I wish you a life filled with joy and happiness. It's hanging in there. And we congratulate you both and ask you to go forward together and enjoy every step of your life ahead. Ladies and gentlemen, may I now present Mr. and Mrs. Stuart and Tiana Shaw.
We'll be right back. I now present our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Stewart and Tiana Shaw.
It'll be a while. My first toast of the evening goes to the bar staff who will keep our classes charged. Okay. Okay, seriously, I am so damn proud of my eldest son, especially today. Looking at him sitting next to his new wife, Tiana, you look absolutely radiant. I just want to quickly reflect on Stuart's life. Tiana, just letting you know that he was a shit of a kid. As a baby, he cried all the time and was so demanding. As a little boy, he was well-mannered, compliant, and had a mature head on his shoulders. This made adults like him, and he learned to have intelligent conversations with adults from a very early age. He became very opinionated and has very strong values, which I'm sure everyone in this room is aware of. He also turned into a bit of a funny bugger. Now, I'm going to tell you a little story. I'm looking around the room. It's very politically incorrect, so I really hope I don't offend anyone. When Stuart and his brother Jay were about 15 and 10 years old, I had a little talk to them about the birds and the bees. I put an offer to them. I put an offer to them that if they ever came home and told me that they were gay, I'd pay for them to go to a high-class brothel and experience a real woman. If after that they still wanted to be gay, then I would accept that. I could see both my boys' minds ticking over, probably in disbelief of what I just said. Finally, Stuart breaks the silence and says, "I'm gay." Anyway, Tiana, I'm sure you can vouch for Stuart's sexuality. Okay. I have to tell you, Tiana, that you've landed quite the catch. You know who is even luckier? It's my son for having found you. You're an exceptional person and who means the world to Stuart, and you also hold a special place in my heart because you're the woman who makes Stuart truly happy. So thank you. Let's drink to the newlyweds. Now, there's one special person who wishes they were here today, Stuart's father, Doug. He would be so damn proud of you. He has missed so many milestones, but today would be the most important. I can see Doug's image looking down on us, his dark brown smiling eyes, cowboy tip forward, shading his eyes, Peter Stuyvesant cigarette hanging out the corner of his mouth. And I can hear him saying, "Proud of you, my little man." I also need to mention the other important people in Stuart's life who aren't here today. Stuart's grandmother, Mari, which is Doug's mum, who I know held a special place in her heart for Stu. Stuart's auntie Niecy, and Uncle George. Even after Stu's dad passed, he kept the connection with his family, visiting them often. Niecy was Stu's favourite auntie. When Stu visited his grandmother in her nursing home, he formed a very strong connection with his Uncle George. Uncle George was so excited to attend today, but God had other plans, and George unexpectedly passed only a few months ago. Next, Stu's other grandmother, my mum, and his Uncle Greg. Again, they were so very proud of Stuart, and my mum especially was fond of Tiana. I just know they all will be looking down on us today and will be so happy for you guys. So let's drink to those who can't be here with us today. Lastly, the best thing about today is the union of our two families. Not only have I gained a daughter-in-law, but I'm now connected to the Smart family. And what a great family they are. And I mean, who knew that Charlene was actually Gary's sister? Anyway, I love you guys. Cheers and thanks, everyone.
Good evening, everyone, family and friends, especially the newlyweds, Tiana and Stuart. Can you stop? Thank you. All right. Tiana was our second child in our family. And from the day she was born, she was well known for infectious laughter and so happy with life. Ah, dear. So I nicknamed her Tizzy Bee, as she was so small and cute with her beautiful blonde hair. When Tiana was three, we decided to enrol her into dancing. Jazz, tap, ballet, just to name a few, and you wouldn't know it, but she was a very shy little girl. Tiz went on and grew confidence to dance at Stepford's in New South Wales and even Dreamworld in Queensland. She also auditioned for the Royal Australian Ballet in Sydney. Her ability to push herself to success has led to what I believe the best nurse's nurse in our community. Definitely. So Tiana met Stuart this time, as you know already, 6 years ago to this day. Yes. I was on a golf trip with the boys when she introduced Stu to Andrea. It was planned that way, I think. So I found out while I was away there was a blue WRX with "Yeah Mate" number plates in the driveway. I said, Andrea, "Who's there?" And she says, "It's just a friend of Tiana's." I said, great. That's what I said. So a few weeks later, maybe a bit earlier, but I got to meet this friend, Stuart. I did like his car, and I felt the need to get to know him. And what better way with a couple of strong Canadian clubs? So we invited him to stay over, and his reply was, no, he couldn't. He had no toothbrush or clean underwear. That was his excuse. So eventually, he said he would stay, and he made a quick trip down to Woolies to get his essential items. It was so funny. Stubborn, but then he came around. So concluding the night, in the morning, we both having a headache, I thought this man was worthy to be a friend, now husband for my Dizzy Bee. They have the same interests and both work on their goals together, and that's a big tick for me. Andrea and I would just like to say to Stuart, look after our little girl, as she's very precious to us, and wish you both all the best through all the challenges, good times, and laughter ahead. So I can ask all of you to raise a toast to Stuart and Tiara.
So my speech isn't, is it necessarily written out and formalised and all on paper. So it's just a few dot points that I thought I'd make a note of and just sort of talk a bit about Stuart and the type of person that he is and the times that I've experienced with Stuart. And, yeah, so it's pretty chill, pretty informal. So I guess our friendship really didn't blossom. We knew each other at school, but it really blossomed after school when we did our first year of our apprenticeship in 2012. So we all stayed in Tamworth. And, yeah, that's when we really started to become good mates. It wasn't really the type of friendship, I guess, that you'd, I don't know, starting from school and then working outside of school. It was just each other saying stupid shit to each other and random stuff that only you and I would find funny. So I won't get into it. You wouldn't understand. But I guess the type of person he is, a few people have touched on it already, he's very, when he gets his mind set on something or he's committed to something, he goes in all 100%. And like a few, two examples that really stood out to me when I thought of that trait of Stuart. You know, definitely one of those is the annual bendy trip that a few of the boys here know about. So when Stuart moved to Western Australia, we thought, you know, Stuart's dead to us now. He's never coming back to bendy. But no, sure enough, the time came around the middle of the year in July and he's like, I'm going to be there. Like, no, you're not, mate. You're not coming all the way across the country for a four-day camping trip to drive another 3 days back to WA. Sure enough, he committed. He drove 3 days non-stop all the way across back to camp with us for 4 days, and then when we were done, drove all the way back again. I'm like, bloody hell, he's committed. And then the second time that really sort of, I don't know, it stuck in my memory, and I think you brought up a photo of it last night when we were sitting around dinner. It was quite funny. It was a reunion of the apprenticeship group that we had in 2012. And I think we all caught up in Sydney in Coogee, and I drove up for the week for the day in that's quite moody. Going down the wrong path now. That's all right. It's all good. It's all right. It is. That's a good sign. Yeah, so we all caught up in Coogee and we didn't really... I was going to go back down to stay back home, so we're going to drive up and come back. But no, Stuart's like, oh, we'll stay in Sydney somewhere. We'll just stay somewhere for the night so we don't have to worry about going back. I'm like, I don't have any money for this, mate. Like, if you want to stay somewhere, by all means. He's like, no, fuck it, I'll find somewhere. I'm like thinking we'll just get a backpacker's hotel or something like that. But no, sure enough, everything was all booked out and the only place that was left was the Crown Plaza and it was like $1,300 a night. I'm like, fuck, you're an idiot. He goes, no, I'll do it. I'll pay it. I'm like, if you're committed to stay here tonight, let's do it. So he's like, all right. So he paid for the hotel room. And he didn't end up staying in that hotel room. I ended up staying in the hotel room that night by myself. He was out busy. So, but he was committed. So I was like, okay, that's fair enough. So, yeah, I guess from those two examples and a few other times, yeah, Stuart, whenever he's set on something, he's got his mind set on something or he really knows what he wants, he 100% commits, and he 100% has set that with you, Tiana. So I can see that for sure from the years that I've known him. So all the best for the future, and I hope he's committed to you for the rest of your marriage together. that's all pretty it. So cool. All right. Cheers.
Thanks, everyone, for coming. Beers in the fridge. Toilet's over there. Yeah, and the fridge, yep. No, but who's seen Bridgerton, by the way?
Bridgerton on Netflix? Bridgerton. Yes.
Okay. So, Miss Tizzerton. Not going to say it's been easy. It hasn't been easy, so I won't say it. Yeah. Could be worse.
Yeah.
Nah, just kidding. Made it. 6 years to the day, and now you're ashore. Woo! On behalf of Tiz, I'd like to thank everyone for attending our wedding today and amazing hosts of Montrose House, Daniela and Cardi, as well as the awesome crew from Chef and I.
Thank you.
As we conclude the formalities, let's say. It's important to mention the commitment our guests that have made, commitment the guests have made today. Travelling from near and far, such as Newcastle, the Hunter, Central Coast, Wallandilly, Wollongong, Grenfell. Grenfell? Hey?
And yeah, keep going.
I've got it.
Sorry. Give it here. Don't get distracted, Stewie. Keep it together, keep it together.
And even from the top end. Casino. I'd like to extend our gratitude to our parents. We truly have the best parents and parents-in-law. Mum, Gaz and Andrea, thank you for everything you have done in leading up to our wedding day. Your support and love over the last 6 years has truly been a blessing, and we are so lucky to have you all in our life.
That sounded scripted.
Your phone now.
Okay. Mum. Oh, God. Okay. There are no words to describe your significance to me in my life. Over the years, if life has taught me one thing, it's that it doesn't come with a manual, it comes with a mother. And I'm so lucky to call you mine. Getting married today doesn't change the fact that I'll always be your little girl, and you'll always be the first one I call when I need advice. I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm so grateful to call you my mum. Okay, Dad. Okay, we don't do the cushy emotion stuff, Dad. But I know I can always turn to you when I need you, and I need your down-to-earth and level-headed advice. You'll always be the first person I call when I need fatherly advice and when I think Stewie's being unreasonable. Such as when he wants to buy another go-kart. Or he wants to buy a boat. Or he wants a Cummins engine diesel patrol, new engine for the patrol. Or another racing simulator.
I don't know what she's talking about.
Your little chuckles on the end of the phone are always what I'll expect. But nevertheless, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm so grateful to call you my dad. Lorraine. Take a sip. Yeah, sure. I'm kidding. I am the luckiest bride in the world to have inherited a mother-in-law like you. You have raised an absolute gentleman, and you should be so proud of yourself. He doesn't make the bed, but he did today. Yes. Thank you for trusting me, our relationship, and the chance to show your son love.
Finally, I'd like to conclude and thank my wife.
You're reading off my speech.
Yeah.
Off my phone. That's so
funny. It's the same speech.
I wrote that for you.
Thank my wife for everything you have done.
That's so funny.
To organise today. It's been a long 20 months of planning and deciding, but we got there. You did write this, didn't you? You look beautiful today, Tiz. And you're the best anyone could ask for.
Thanks, Stu.
Thank you for embracing this wild journey called marriage with me. We're like 6 hours in. I know many people who are not here today with us would be very proud of the person you are and life we have created together. Could I ask that we please raise our glasses to love, to life and happiness, and join us in celebrating our first dance as husband and wife. Ooh.
Stu and Tiz, before you cut your cake and take to the floor for your first dance, I'd like to take this opportunity again to let you know, Stu, how proud your dad. For anyone who doesn't know of my connection, I'm not quite just the paid help today. I was Stu's stepmum for a few years when his dad was still alive, and I pay homage to Lorraine and Stu for including me in his life, and I'm very grateful for that. And then, as Lorraine said earlier, his dad would be busting with pride to see him today, and he would be very, very proud of your choice of wife. He would be... very, very proud. Now, I would like you to do something else for me. I'd like you to hold hands and look into each other's eyes. And I'm sure no one here would deny the love you share, but there is something that you should know. Statistically, the person you are now looking at is the person most likely to murder you.
Thank you. Don't need to come from where you go. Don't need to come from Canada.